Hey everyone, welcome back to Fatal Frame 5, Maiden of Black Water. We are on the 13th drop, and we're surveilling the house and keeping it safe for the girls who seem to not wake up. Is there anything out here? I just exercised some girl that was the one responsible for Fuyuhi's death in the beginning. So, let's get back to the cameras. I hate this part of the game. But I'm not doing too bad. Not too bad at all. Okay, so far so good. I'm safe. Always seems safe. Oh my.
You will not escape.
It's the tall lady.
What is she doing here? How did she even fit in here? What? Which hallway is it? Oh, it was this one. Jesus Christ.
You will not escape.
I'm afraid to get up. But where did the tall lady go? Okay, fine. And this is what I mean. These guys take up way too much space to be in here, like... Are they both gone now? Oh yeah, I did it! Not bad at all. Oh, I missed the other. There we go. I want your points. I should probably heal again too. Ready? Okay, fine. Tall lady, are you here? Something here. Oh, when did that get here? I need that. Ugh. That shocked me that I was speechless. If you guys saw, it looked like an actual hand, not a ghost hand. That was incredibly creepy. Tall lady? Hello? How did you fit in small house, tall lady? Oh my god, what a trip. Ooh. And she's like, you're not gonna escape, so that's very concerning. Okay. Here we go, Ri's journal. Ri must have been writing this before going to bed. But how come we didn't see it before? This might be the end. My body is growing colder, and my blood runs clear like water. My body shakes with the mountain. I can't move. I wanted Mr. Hojo to get away at least, but he can't escape. He has become an outsider. He must choose. The one he doesn't choose will be thrown away. I don't think Mr. Hojo will be able to do it, but it's already too late. He needs to choose someone. He needs to end it with someone. Oh, that's creepy. He's not waking up. Let's check on everyone else again. Okay, let's see what other horrors await us today. Not all lady. As long as I don't have to fight in Hisoka's room, because... Who was that? It just collapsed. And a ring is phoning. Yes, I am aware I said ring and phoning. Let's see, are you still good? I think that was his friend that was collapsing onto the floor. See if we'll shot him again. Oh no, it just gets all ooky. Okay, let's go. Oh my.
You will not escape.
What are you doing here? What a weirdo. Surprised she fit in this house. I was like, I thought I saw something on the floor. Okay, okay. Oh, come on. Trying to answer the phone. But I was right, it is the phone. Kazuya, what happened to you? Why are you like tree bark sounding? By it, so I have to test it before the thing happens. Little fatal frame thing. Oh, that's that one. Okay, I was like, you're somewhere, please don't hurt me. Please don't hurt me. I love you. You're my best friend and then you die. Okay, that's a little too much. Come on, you're almost there. Woo! Oh, okay, I think he's good. Oh, the ring isn't phoning anymore. But there's a ruby somewhere. Or is there? This book seems to be about reliquaries. It seems to be about inside the reliquaries. The black boxes found on Ahikami were filled with life, with death, and with fear. In short, they were filled with human sacrifices. Shrine maidens were put in these reliquaries to protect the locals by appeasing the Shadow Spring. This Shadow Spring served as a bridge to the netherworld. In other words, beneath the water, the source of all life, exists the underworld. The black water came from the underworld itself, and with it came disaster and ruin. The border between life and death was faint in that place. The shrine maidens were said to take on the memories of people who came to die. This seems to be similar to the spirit channeling seen in other parts of the country. To take on the memories of the dying is to share in death. The maidens glanced people's souls as they died, taking their secrets as they were sealed into reliquaries. The shrine maidens became one with the water to connect with the people they glanced. The shrine maidens buried people to their death via the water. The maidens of Mount Hikami presided over death, but this may have been an effort to protect those still living. Okay. Now we know a little bit about why they're being put in these Miko boxes. I say Miko boxes, I think I've explained it before because of the Let's Play I watched for this game way before it was released in the US. Okay. Here they're just called reliquaries. The religion practiced on Mount Hikami relied on the shrine maidens. They were the ones guarding the border between worlds. They had two main duties. The first one was to oversee the deaths of those who made the pilgrimage to Mount Hikami. And the second one...
And in order to preserve the water's purity, shrine maidens were chosen to be immortal flowers, human sacrifices, or pillars offered up to the water.
I like how it's kind of going over the main point of...
They were placed inside those black boxes.
Sorry. I didn't know you were going to keep talking. Oh, there was someone there. Did you guys see it? Rewind back, and she was on the top right corner. Yeah, but I like how they're, going over the they're going over the plot like very briefly, but they're going over the whole point of the whole boxes, the maidens, and the black water.
There's three.
He died. Okay, that was easy. Oh, you're almost dead. Why so weak? Okay, that's not what I wanted to do. Yeah, but she was standing here. No, she's not. Let's check in on the ladies. How are the ladies doing? The ladies seem fine. The two Hinosakis are sleeping together. They deserve a rest. I have to watch over everyone though, not just them. Well, that was different. Neko, he addressed them by their last name and added a counter. The two Hinosakis. It can't just be Miyu and Miku, or the family, or the Hinosakis. Oh, Mr. Hojo, you are quite an enigma of some sorts. Okay, back to this. I hope this is over, because I really hate these. I mean, there's only two of them in the whole game, but they're still really annoying. And there's not a lot of room in this house, as you can tell. But I'm doing good. What? Where? I think that was Hisoka's room. Yeah, I think it was Hisoka's room. Okay, let's go there then. Yeah, because that's where we started, right? Yes, I believe so. Okay. Alright, well, let's get going. So eerily silent, it's so creepy. Oof. Doors. There's just a long... Well, her room's right in the middle, so I guess there is no long way. Ah, the static. Hello? I'll go back to confirm. Hisoka, she looks like she's having a nightmare, but otherwise seems fine. She spent days trapped on that Hikami. I'd like to ask her about what she saw there. But I've got more urgent things on my hands right now. I should keep watching the camera feeds. Ghost Brides. An old book has fallen on the floor. I can see the words ghost marriage. It looks like it's by the folklorist Keiji Watarai. Okay, well, those are two separate things. That says Ghost Brides and you're reading Ghost Marriage. I wonder if it's the same translation, I guess, in Japanese. Maidens within the casket suffer through an eternal cycle of life and death as they slowly melt into the water. To protect the mountain, the shrine maidens must endure the pain and suffering alone until they can take no more. There is a ceremony to soothe the suffering of the maiden's souls, allowing the pillar to persist longer. This is the ghost marriage. Living men are brought to the mountain as grooms for the suffering shrine maidens. They choose their maiden and then exchange their vows. At the moment their souls join, her soul is said to return to this world. The maiden is then placed back into her casket, groom in tow, so that when she can continue to uphold the border between life and death. Until the maiden is bound by ghost marriage, she is alone. She must wait to be chosen. This ritual invokes emotions and transcends life and death. Perhaps this is part of the deep-rooted beliefs of this region, where nature is both feared and revered by the people. I say revered, but the voice of Hojo said revered. Okay. But ooh. I thought she opened her eyes. That was creepy. I think it was just me. Oh, a journal by Hisoka. Looks like it's Hisoka's. Maybe there's some kind of clue. I couldn't make it. Just as I thought I had her, she fell. Akari. I couldn't save her. Forgive me. Those words still echo in my mind. Maybe in chasing after Akari, I pushed her too far. I'm so relieved. Thank you. The forced niceties made it so much harder. After that call, I cried so much, I thought I might die. She slipped through my fingers. I feel like Yuri will too. And that's only if we mess up. Is here, but in her good form, not her evil form. I hope you guys have picked up on that. The black watered one is all drenched and, well, black because of the black water and on her clothes and her skin and everything. Because, I mean, we saw it the last time we played with Ren when he went to go save Ri, and then it turned out to be her, and then it was the black water, and it was just a mess. Alright, I'm gonna stop this here, and we're gonna hopefully finish this drop in the next episode. Thanks for watching. Bye!